And we've got 7 weeks of the NFL already in the books. Johnny Mack in about 20, football in the 20s, all things Philadelphia Eagles, Lloyd Vance in the 5 o'clock hour, Vance's view. I'll close with the recap in the world of fights this week in D.C., Maryland, and of course, the snooze fest that was Shakur Stevenson against Herring. But hey, I give the kid credit, man. He fought the fight, and that's what it's all about. But I have to begin with the Philadelphia Eagles. And why not, right? Because you look around the NFC East. Dallas has a bye. They're sitting back, running away with the East. The Washington football team has been one of the biggest disappointments thus far in the season as they get waxed by Green Bay 24-10. They fall to 2-5. The Giants, my Giants, how about the picks? 4-1 over the weekend, Q's picks? Are you kidding me? Absolutely on fire. I told you guys it was a lock. It was a done deal. The Giants were going to beat Carolina outright, and that's exactly what they did. Darnold gets benched. The defense comes alive. Daniel Jones with his arm and his hands and his legs and his moxie. So good for the Giants. Now you go up in a bee's nest, if you will, Monday night on the road against Kansas City. And then you have the Philadelphia Eagles, who yesterday traded their backup Joe Flacco for the Jets for a 6th-round pick. The Jets, by the way, just got blasted by New England, part of our Q's picks, 54-13. Now, that move by the Eagles tells me a couple things. It tells me now on the depth chart, from a quarterback standpoint, and I know people don't want to hear this. Folks, I'm telling you right now, it's just a matter of time before the Eagles decide to turn to Gardner Minshew. I'm telling you right now. Because on Sunday, the Philadelphia Eagles decided, let's go out to the West Coast and take on the Raiders. Let's show everyone that, okay, we had the nice win against a bad Carolina team. We hung tough, right? We hung tough against the Bucs, which they did. And then with plenty of time to spare and a couple extra days, you go out west and you take on the Raiders, and Derek Carr looks like the next coming of Jim Plunkett. Guy looked like an all-pro, Kenny Stabler. And he lights up the Philadelphia Eagles and their secondary. And in a game where the Eagles weren't even competitive, they got that first touchdown, the first drive, and that was pretty much it. That 33-22 score was not indicative of the contest. The Raiders could have put up 45. You got an, oh, by the way, garbage touchdown to make it 33-22 as opposed to 33-14. Carr went off 31 of 34, 323, couple touchdowns. Hurts, hollow shaded numbers, 18 of 34, 236. Those numbers came early for Hurts. He did not play well. They could not run the ball in the second half again, even though they tried to do it in the first half with a little bit of success, rushing for 135 yards. They had no answer for the Raiders defense. They had no, I'm sorry, for the Raiders ground attack. They had no answer for Carr. He spread the ball all over the place. And when you have time to prepare and you come out and you play the way the Philadelphia Eagles played the other day, it's a new low. It's embarrassing. It really is. Because once again, this head coach, and I'm trying to be patient with this guy, I really am, but this head coach to me looks like he should actually be behind a deli counter, pulling tickets, not calling plays, because he looks absolutely clueless. Absolutely. I can see it right. Number 16, sliced turkey. Number 16. Number 16, sliced turkey. Sirianni looks overmatched. I mean, here's the harsh reality. For the people out there that for some inexplicable reason had this idea that the Philadelphia Eagles were going to win 10 games, what the hell were you talking about? For the sharps, for the odds makers, you know what? I'm pulling your gambling card. to think for one moment this team had the talent after 1 week, after one lousy, stupid friggin' week in the NFL when they beat Atlanta and they went down to Atlanta and Jalen Hurts hooks up with Smith. All we heard on social media, get used to this combination, Hall of Famer to Hall of Famer. Then you go out and you stink up the joint. You stink up the joint. The only player that's actually showed up this year, okay, who's played has been their defensive tackle, Javon Hargrave. That's it. Graham gets early. Kerrigan gets old. I'll get started on Fletcher Cox, because this guy's already mentally checked out. Mentally checked out. And I don't care about fantasy football. I don't care that Jalen Hurts has scored 43.4% of his fantasy points in the fourth quarter when they're always coming from behind and always trailing. Who cares? I'm telling you this right now, folks. I'm telling you this. As the day is long right now, as we fast approach winter, and it's getting darker out earlier, Jalen Hurts is going to, he's going to be benched. It's just a matter of when. It's not going to shock me if Sirianni turns around to Minshew, the mustache, and says, look, give me a little juice with this offense. Hurts doesn't have the draft pedigree the organizational support was thinking he did. He doesn't. He just doesn't. And it's unfortunate because I like the kid, okay? And you get some flashes. But again, the lack of effectiveness, the inaccuracy, not reading, you know, going through your progressions, not being able to run the football, which he has nothing to do with. That's a want, an offensive line. That's a play calling. The inconsistent defense, which has just been horrible. No linebacker play. And this is what you get. On merit, by the grace of God, 2-5. And I'll tell you something else. You might want to pencil this in. You might want to mark this down today at 4:12 on the Tuesday edition of BYP. The Philadelphia Eagles are going to lose outright to Detroit. They are going to lose to the Lions. I'm calling it right now. I'm calling it right now. They have played so hard, they are due. You just get the sense they are so due. And is it going to get easier for Philly? Chargers, Broncos, bad Saints team, bad Giant team, bad Giants. You'll squeeze in maybe two wins, maybe three. But this notion they were going to win 10? This notion that all of a sudden Smith to Hurts, Hurts to Smith, this deadly combo, it just hasn't panned out. And the GM is the biggest culprit. Howie Roseman is the biggest culprit. Howie Roseman needs to get that timeout that we talked about a couple years ago. Let's not for one instant think that Roseman shouldn't be held accountable, that Roseman shouldn't escape culpability. This guy has stunk as a GM over the last several years. Let's not forget that. He is, at the end of the day, responsible for as much as what happens with the Philadelphia Eagles than Sirianni, than the defensive coordinator, than the players, all the way down the line. And I don't want to hear this tough schedule. Young players, young coaching staff, trying to implement scheme. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. Roseman has done a horrible job. A horrible job with this team over the last several years. And we're seeing it by the stinky product on the field. And what's it going to take to fire this guy? Serious. What is it going to take for Jeffrey Lurie to finally say, you know what, that's it, I'm done? And if it goes to you know what, and they win 4 or 5 games and finish 4-13, 5-12, who's to say Jeffrey Lurie doesn't blow it up and fire everyone? Fire everyone. You know, Gannon, is it going to shock me if Jonathan Gannon gets canned in the middle of the season? No. if the Eagles are ready to roll along with Sirianni, say for next season, so you might sit there and say, well, why are you going to move on from your defensive coordinator right now? Well, that's not going to fix the biggest problem. Hey, so what? Sometimes you got to make a change just to do it. Heads have to fall. And I'm telling you, it's bad losses, right? It's bad losses. You had the disaster against the Cowboys. You didn't show up for the Raiders. I mean, this is a bad football team right now. And then I got to listen to one of your highest paid players and Fletcher Cox, who for some reason decided to say, I don't get paid to play screens. You get paid to sack the quarterback. All right. You get paid to sack the quarterback, do you, Fletcher? Well, then, let's see how that has worked out for you. Because you get paid an enormous amount of money. And the last time I checked, Fletcher, in 7 games, Fletcher, you've sacked the quarterback, Fletcher, 1 lousy time. So if that's the case, Eagles should recoup some money back from you, my friend. You've been a non-factor for the Philadelphia Eagles for some time now. For some time now. You really have. So I don't want to hear this crap from Fletcher Cox. It's a bad football team right now. It is. And then you got to watch Carson Wentz go out there and make some plays. You might as well get rid of the Deshaun Watson pipe dream. That's not happening. And look, Howie can turn around and say, well, we've got potentially 3 first-round picks right now as it would stand in next year's draft. Hey, fine. This guy is like Costanza, right? He covers up for the mistakes. He's the best at it. But you've got a veteran who has at times been dominant in his career, who's not that guy anymore, Fletcher Cox, doesn't like the defensive coordinator scheme, okay? That's number one. You've got a secondary that all I heard was going to be stout this year. They've given up big play after big play after big play. It doesn't matter. I got to watch a 3rd and 13 and Zay Jones catch a 43-yarder. And then Fletcher Cox says, I didn't agree what was called on the defense. So you got that disconnect. You had the offensive line. You had the Lane Johnson issues. They're getting older. Sirianni doesn't have any answers. I mean, how do you allow a 43-yard completion on 3rd and 13? Gannon picked the wrong time to leave poor Stevie Nelson out there alone in man coverage, did he not? You lost Miles Sanders. Folks, the ship, it be a-sinking, and it ain't good. And it's going to get worse. All right, 18 past 4 o'clock hour, just cranking up on a Tuesday edition of BYP. Good to be back in the saddle with you guys. We'll take you up to 6 o'clock. Johnny Mack! On the other side, football in the 20s. We'll dive into the mess that is the Philadelphia Eagles. We'll go around the league with him. Lloyd in the 5 o'clock hour. We'll talk a little NBA, the World Series game one. Are you going to watch the World Series? It should have been one of my questions of the day because in this market, no one is. No, I'm not. I'll flip through, but then you got the Sixers and the Knicks as well. And then we'll talk a little sweet science to close it out. Keep it locked in, 20 past 4 o'clock hour. Johnny Mack. Football in the 20s on the other side.